don't remember that episode. Welcome to Do You Know Your Music? So today we're going to be doing Poems, Prayers, and Promises. This is John Denver's first, like, album that has a lot of hits on it, I would say.
So, first of all, are we even able to understand you with all that metal in your mouth?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. We just had to get the elephant in the room out of the way.
Oh, okay.
That's address good. That you now have some braces going on.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Fresh. Mm-hmm. Freshly learning how to talk again.
Yeah.
Okay. I won't belabor it anymore.
Anyway, let's just start.
So did you say what year this was from?
1971.
1971. Okay. And this is his biggest album, in your opinion?
I don't know what his biggest album was.
Okay.
Actually, his biggest album is John Denver Sings.
Sure.
So, let's get started.
Okay.
First up, we got Poems, Prayers, and Promises. Title track, one of his more famous ones for sure.
Yeah.
I've been lately thinking nice one. About my lifetime,
all the things I've done. Yeah, great song.
Yeah.
Where is this right? I mean, is this one of your favorites?
Favorite albums? Yeah.
No, song.
Maybe, yeah. Then we have cover of Let It Be.
So we're keeping our Beatles cover streak alive.
Next episode, I think it ends.
Oh, no. But this is like, what, 4 or 5 albums now?
Yeah.
This is a good version. I like mm-hmm. this. I haven't listened to this one much.
Then we have My Sweet Lady. Kind of famous. He did another version that was more famous in 1977. I think it was just a single, though.
Oh, okay. This hasn't been on any of his previous ones. Okay. Yeah, I know this one. It's a good song.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of mellow in this album so far.
Mm-hmm.
Very ballady.
Not until this next one, which is a deep cut that a lot of people like, and I think it's kind of good. Got What an Indian.
Yeah, this is kind of rocking.
Like this one. Good one.
Yeah.
It's got backup vocals on it. And we got a cover of Junk. I heard this version before I heard the Paul McCartney one.
Yeah. Whose version is better?
Paul McCartney's, I would have to say, though.
Okay. But this is a great version, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So, this came out in 71, but yeah. Junk came out in what year?
70. But it was written in India for the White Album.
Oh,
okay. I find it interesting that you chose this one. This one's kind of like a deep cut, I would say, though.
Yeah.
Then we have Gospel Changes. Don't know much about this one, really. This
time around, another ballady song. Kind of got a gospel flair to it, maybe.
Then we start side two with one of my personal favorite John Denver songs, and probably one of his most famous ones, Take Me Home, Country Roads.
Probably one of his most famous ones.
Definitely.
This is far and away the most famous John Denver song.
Has 325,598,567 plays.
That's a lot of plays.
Compared to Give Me a Song on the album.
I mean, even the next most famous one is what? Sunshine on My Shoulder.
On this album?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's still only.
Well, we got another kind of famous one. I guess I'd rather be in Colorado.
Famous? I mean, it's a great, good song, I guess, but I don't know if it's famous.
It's on a lot of greatest hits albums. He wrote a lot of songs about Colorado, I realized.
Yeah. It's mm-hmm. an inspiration for him. He lived out in Colorado about this time, or do you know?
I think he went to Colorado in like 1970 was the first time he ever went there.
Oh, really? Okay.
Then we have Sunshine on My Shoulders.
Another classic.
Love this one. Good one.
Yeah.
It's got some strings in it. Find them.
I'm starting to doubt you.
Never mind. They only have around and around. This might have been a B-side, I think.
Don't know this one. This was the B-side to Sunshine on My Shoulders?
Maybe. Or it might have been Take Me Home Country Roads, but it was I think this was a B-side to some song. Then we have Fire and Rain. James Taylor cover.
Okay.
Second James Taylor cover.
Right.
I haven't actually listened
Caroline
to this one.
Caroline on My Mind in the last one? Yeah.
On Take Me Tomorrow. Just yesterday morning, they let me know. I haven't really
they
listened
have similar
to
styles, so that's not surprising.
Yeah. He was in one of our first Battle of Bands episodes.
James Taylor?
Yeah, John Denver and James Taylor.
Oh, okay.
But you don't remember
put
that
episode? Card up there for that one.
You don't remember that episode?
I can honestly say I do not.
Oh, okay.
But I'll go back and watch it.
Then we have The Box. Once upon a time, this is a story. Hushabye,
around about the wondrous stage. Was this on the original album?
Yeah. Came across a sort of box, bound up with chains and locked with locks. I wonder if he wrote this.
Like a poem. Kindly
do not touch. Charles Stilwell and Kendrick Lascelles wrote it. About, all with a flourish and a shout.
Pretty in those wondrous days. I feel like he's doing Night Before Christmas or something.
It says he like that. And the chain whiz
since though it's war. What's the story about?
The box. So now it's time for my item from the background.
Okay.
I was going to let you pick, but you're going to pick next week because I wanted to just show an item.
Okay. But I get to pick next week?
Yeah.
Ooh, interesting. Maybe I should start scoping it out what I want to choose.
So I got these Russian thingies that they're like
babushkas.
So we got John Lennon on the outside. Then we open it. Paul McCartney. He's got a UK on the top of his head. We open it up. We got George Harrison. It keeps going and going. We open it up. Ringo Starr.
Poor little Ringo in the very inside. What's
no.
In the-
oh, there's something in the inside. A little beetle.
So, where did you get these?
St. Patrick's Day, 2020.
Okay, that's when. You don't know where it was just purchased for you and delivered for St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah.
Interesting. Sounds like a mom find. I don't know.
Yeah. That's these are always
cool.
Fun to play with, kind of, though.
Yeah. I mean, the artwork's interesting.
They're like,
is it just the images pulled directly from the album?
I guess so. He has a UK head on top of him, and then John has a guitar for some reason. I don't know. George and Ringo are kind of lame, though. They don't get anything special.
Mm.
They don't even have the hat on that they wore on the cover.
It's true. They both had hats. Oh, but this is authentic. This says made in Russia, so...
They probably just put that on there to make it sound cooler.
I wonder if John likes it.
He does. So there you have it. Like and subscribe. Click the bell for notifications, and we'll see you next time. Bye.